recession.
Hi, Flesh. It's so good to see you. I'm glad that you're here with me again today. I am Reverend Jess, and this is our teen message. So I'm glad to see you all. I hope that over this past week you have done your homework. I hope that you've been kind to your parents and to your siblings, please. And I also hope that you have had an opportunity to see our digital Easter program. I hope that you enjoyed that. If you haven't, check out the playlist on our YouTube channel in our children and youth content section, and you'll see the video from last Sunday. Thank you for submitting, those of you who submitted portions of that poem for me and my digital worship leaders. I am very appreciative of your contribution, friends. Thank you so much. Today we are going to have a lesson on John chapter 20. And we're going to talk about what happens right after Easter, right after Jesus has risen from the dead. So we're going to start actually at verse 19 of chapter 20 and read down through the end. How far am I going to go today? We're going to read until I stop reading. Yeah. I don't think I'm going to go all the way to the end, but we're going to read most of the chapter, or the remainder of the chapter. Okie dokie. So let's start at verse 19. Messing up. Verse 19. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the disciples were together with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven." Now, Thomas, also known as Didymus, one of the 12, was not with the disciples when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said unto them, "Unless I see the nail marks in his hands, and put my fingers where the nails were, and put my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. Though the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here. See my hands? Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." I went to verse 27. I really love this passage, right? I think it's so interesting because it's so real, right? Look. The disciples are holed up in a house, afraid of what the world is gonna do to them. And they have reason to be fearful, right? Their leader, Jesus, they had just seen die on the cross. And they had no ability to stop what was happening. Jesus had been telling them that he was going to become king and he was going to die, but they didn't think it was gonna be like this. See, they understood the king part. They didn't understand the dying to become king part. They didn't understand that. And when Jesus died, they saw a death in a dream, a vision, a thought of what their world might be like. So they are fearful and they go and hide in their home. I don't know about you, but I've been in some pretty fearful situations recently. Sometimes it can feel like with the way the world is right now that there is no way anything good could happen to us. And it's completely understandable how someone could feel fearful in this time. We are literally holed up in our homes. Like, you can't leave your house. And what the virus that we are fearing is in the air. You don't know who has it. You don't know how you can catch it. It can cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of fear. And for some people, when they're very fearful, they choose to hide, to shelter, to come together and stick together and wait things out. That's what happened to the disciples. And it was what probably should have happened, right? Just wait it out. Mourn our friend who died. Wait for kind of the crowds to die down. And then we'll start coming out little by little. But Jesus has a different vision for the disciples' lives. Jesus knew that they would be fearful. So what he does is show up where they are. Jesus brings peace where they are. Remember, look and see what the scripture says. Scripture says that Jesus shows up in the midst, right? The doors are locked for fear of Jewish leaders. Jesus came and stood among them. Doesn't say that Jesus knocked on a door. It doesn't say that Jesus walked through a door. It just says Jesus came and stood among them. We don't know how he appeared there, but I think what's most important in that is that Jesus showed up where the disciples needed him, in their place of fear. And he comes with something to give them, peace. Jesus says, peace be with you. And I don't know about you, but when I'm in a fearful situation, I'm in an uncomfortable place, and somebody who I respect comes in and says something like, it's gonna be okay, it changes the whole mood of the situation. See, Jesus says, peace be unto you. And the disciples' response is this. They're overjoyed because they see their Lord. They see their friend. They see their mentor. And he says, peace be unto you. Look, when I was growing up, I had a little fear of the dark, right? I didn't like being in the dark. And one of the things that my parents got me to help me deal with having a fear of being in dark places was a nightlight. A nightlight. It's very simple, right? Nightlights just shine enough light to where you can see a little bit more, but it doesn't keep you from falling asleep. What it does is it brings some comfort. It shines a bit of light to ease my troubled mind. And here's what I like about what Jesus does when Jesus shows up. Jesus shows up with the purpose and the plan to ease some troubled minds. Jesus shows up and at his first peace be with you, he just wants to calm their fears. But it's interesting because Jesus doesn't say peace be with you once. He says it again. But this time when he says peace be with you, he says more. He says the Father has sent me and I am sending you. Jesus brings peace, but he also comes with a plan for the disciples' future. Jesus isn't just bringing peace for right now, but Jesus is setting up a way for there to be peace for everyone in the future. Jesus says to his disciples, I am sending you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you, which tells me something. Jesus knew that he was not going to be here for forever and that the world needed peace brought to them. The same kind of peace that the disciples felt when they saw Jesus, Jesus says, I'm sending you as my disciples out to bring that peace to somebody else. Not only am I sending you, but I'm sending you with something. Remember how Jesus showed up, but he came with peace? Jesus says, I'm sending you, but I'm giving you the Holy Spirit. He says, receive now the Holy Spirit. And he says, if you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are forgiven. If you do not, they are not forgiven. Which really is just Jesus saying, I'm giving you some authority. So Jesus came to the world and he preached, he taught, but also he delivered us from our sinful nature through his death and resurrection. Jesus says, I'm giving to you, my disciples, the power of the Holy Spirit, which will live inside of you. And because you have the Holy Spirit, you can go and care for the world around you. Listen, this can be kind of heavy stuff, but I want you to know that as believers in Christ, our job is more than just to be saved ourselves, right? You hear me talk about that a lot. It's not just about you. It's about you going into the world and being who God has called you to be in the spaces God has called you to be. It's kind of like this, right? God has given you a gift, and whatever that gift is, whether that is singing or you're great at math or you're an actor or you're an athlete or you are a caring person or you are a loving person or you are a volunteer or you are a scientist, whatever it is that God has called you to do, God is sending you out not just to do the work, but also to be his light in that area so that people who need peace can receive it from you. How, Jessica? How do they receive peace from me? By you showing them what it means to be in relationship with God. That's the thing, friends. Jesus sends his disciples out so that they can care for the world. And he sends them with the Holy Spirit inside of them. And that same Holy Spirit that's inside of them lives inside of you and lives inside of me. So when we go out, we can bring peace to the world also. But that's not it. We're not done. Jesus talks about peace one more time because inevitably, somebody misses out on Jesus's first vision of being seen by the disciples. Thomas wasn't there. And when the disciples tell Thomas all about what happened, Thomas says, I need to see the nails in his hands. I need to see the scars of the nails. I want to put my finger in there. Not only that, but I want to put my hand in his side where they pierced him. That's the only way I'm going to believe. And Jesus shows up, he shows his hands, he tells him to stop doubting and believe. And so what happens is we often talk about talk about Thomas as doubting Thomas. And Thomas sometimes gets the short end of the stick. We talk bad about Thomas because he was doubting it. Jesus had to show up for him physically, for him to put his hand in his fingers and the nails in his hands and side hand in his side and all of that. But I want you to consider this, right? Just consider this. Many of us find ourselves in the position of Thomas. We find ourselves needing something extra than just the word about how good God is. We want to know for ourselves. We want a little bit more. We want Jesus to show up in a certain way. And I hear you're like, no, that's not me. But think about it. How many times have you said, Lord, just get me through this test? Lord, just help me deal with this situation. Lord, I know you're real, but I need you to show up for real in this instance. There are going to be times in your life where you feel like that. Lord, I need a little extra. And here's the thing. Even when Thomas is doubting, even though Thomas doesn't believe just on the word, Jesus still shows up for Thomas and brings peace. See, Jesus is going to do whatever is necessary. God is going to go wherever God has to go in order to bring you peace. And by peace, I don't just mean you feeling good. I mean you being in a good place. I mean you being in relationship with him. I mean you being connected to God like never before. Jesus is going to bring you peace wherever you are. Even if that means he has to show up again so you can put your finger in his hand, in the scar prints of his hand, and put your hand in his side. Jesus is going to show up. Jesus is going to go the extra mile. Jesus will be where you need him to be. He's already there. Here's the part where we get it mixed up, though. When Jesus shows up and he shows himself to Thomas, Thomas's response is to accept Jesus at his word. I think sometimes we miss Jesus showing up for us because we don't accept the gift of God when God comes. We don't accept the sign. We don't accept the help. We don't accept God's presence. So, what do we do with all of this? What I want you to remember is that Jesus is bringing you peace. Jesus wants you to have peace. And right now, in the world that we're living in, I don't know what greater gift God can bring me. I'm excited because I know that Jesus will show up in my darkness, my dark situation, with something, and that's called peace. I'm grateful because God doesn't just want me to keep the peace that he gives me to myself. He wants me to share that with the world so that when I get peace, where the people that I'm designed to touch, that if I'm really doing this thing right, I ought to be bringing peace to those situations as well, to their lives. But also this, in those times when I find myself in the seat of doubting Thomas, where I find myself worrying and not trusting at the word of God, that God will show up for me and still bring peace. Jesus will come and meet me wherever I am and bring peace. And I want to encourage you of that, that God sees you wherever you are. And if you are in need of the love of the Lord, he's coming to bring it to you. You just have to be willing to receive it. Look, guys, that's really our lesson for today. I want to challenge you to be a peace bearer to someone today. So I want you to think of somebody in your life who you can bring a little sunshine, bring a little peace to. You know, maybe clean the dishes before your mother tells you to this week. Or, spend extra time with your sibling, with your younger sibling, so that your parents can get a little bit of a break, you know. Maybe turn in your homework without having to be reminded. Or call your grandparent, your aunt, your uncle, your cousin, and just say, hey, I just want to let you know I've been thinking about you. Bring some peace to somebody today, okay? Listen, so you may or may not have heard, that we will not be going to convention this year. We won't be going. And not only will we be going, but we won't be going, but nobody will be going. They've canceled convention all around. So we are looking for ways to celebrate you all and have a trip at the end of the summer. I want you to know that you can always share with me your ideas, your thoughts. You can find me at Men Just Kemp. You can find me on that on Instagram, Just Kemp on Facebook. And you can email me, minjesskemp@gmail.com. You can email me anytime if you have ideas. Excuse me, along with that, we are looking for ways to, when we are able to get back together, hang out and have a good time. So I've heard your thoughts about Camp Eagle and Alakin and Fiesta Texas. I've heard those things, and I am trying to figure out what we're gonna do based on the availability of us being able to go out. Okay, so keep your ear to the ground and listen up, and I'll tell you more when I know more. Other than that, I think that's everything. Oh, you almost got away. But I did not forget, memory verse. Thor, this week, it's going to be John chapter 20, verses 21 and 22. It says this, again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit." All right, y'all. Know that I love you and I care for you. We'll probably be doing another digital hangout, in a few days, at the end of this week, maybe next week. I don't know. Check it out. I'll let you know. I miss you. I care for you. I'll see y'all later. Oh, and check out this funny video that I just saw on TikTok. It's all about what we talked about today. Okay. Love y'all. Bye. I die for you.